Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's see the best alkyne addition reaction, the addition of hydrogen. We've seen the addition of hydrogen to an alkene. The addition reaction has a catalyst, palladium on carbon below the arrow, and forms an alkane. This is a syn addition, a hydrogenation, an alkene reduction. Perfect. How about alkynes? If we treat an alkyne with H2 and palladium on carbon, we get an addition. It's a syn addition, and the resulting alkene is therefore a cis-alkene, or Z-alkene if you prefer. As soon as the alkene is formed, however, it can continue to react, undergo another addition, and form the same alkane we saw in the top reaction. You normally cannot stop this reaction halfway. If you react an alkyne with H2 and palladium on carbon, you get the alkane. It would be really nice if you could stop at the alkene, and chemists have figured out how to do this. The old school option is to use H2 with palladium on carbon and barium sulfate, BASO4. This system is called Lindlar's catalyst. The presence of barium poisons the catalyst and allows the reaction to stop at the alkene. The more modern approach is to use a different catalyst, H2 with nickel boride. Great, we can make the cis alkene. Is it possible to make the trans-alkene or E-alkene? Why, yes it is. On the left, we have a drawing of a flask that is filled with liquid ammonia mixed with sodium metal, sodium zero. This mixture forms a dark blue solution that people call the sea of electrons. This is a powerful reducing medium. If we react an alkyne, in the middle of the screen, with sodium in ammonia, then you get the trans-alkene. Or the E-alkene. We won't go into the mechanism of this reaction, but it works well. It is called, as you see at the top of the slide, the dissolving metal reduction. So when it comes to alkynes, we can reduce the triple bond all the way to the alkane. We can also stop at the alkene and can control whether the alkene is cis or trans. We have a lot of options when we add hydrogen across an alkyne.